In this problem, a 10 kilogram sled is on a horizontal surface and it's given a kick. The sled moves with an initial speed of 2 meters per second, and the coefficient of kinetic friction between the sled and the ice is 0.1, and we have to use conservation of energy to find the distance traveled by the sled. And the sled comes to a rest at the end, that means final speed is zero. So let's start by visualizing the problem. I'm going to label the initial state and final state. At the initial state, before we identify the knowns and unknowns, I'm going to label the height is equal to zero level, and then I'm going to identify the knowns and unknowns. Initial velocity is 2 meters per second. Final velocity, or the speed, final speed is zero because the sled comes to a rest. I wanted to emphasize on the speed because in the kinetic energy equation we have speed, right? And we are going to calculate the distance traveled by the sled. And the coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.1. There's a relative motion between the sled and the ice, so it's a kinetic friction, and mass of the sled is 10 kilograms. And now I'm going to draw a free body diagram for the sled, and in the free body diagram I'm going to show all the forces acting on the sled. And just keep in your mind, you give a kick, so initially you apply a force, and then when the sled is in motion, there is no applied force to the right, so weight is directly downwards. And then you have the normal force directly upwards because the ice is pushing on the sled up. And then the kinetic friction opposes the motion. It is to the left. The sled is moving to the right and there's no applied force. And I'm going to draw the work diagram. And in the work diagram, so remember we have two conservative forces in this course. We talk about the force of gravity and then spring force. And non-conservative forces, here we have the normal force. It's a non-conservative force, but you can see the angle between the normal force and the distance is 90 degrees, so the work done by normal force is zero. And then the next force, next non-conservative force, is the kinetic friction force. Kinetic friction opposes the motion. The object is moving to the right, so the displacement vector is to the right. The angle between the kinetic friction and the displacement is 180 degrees. So that was the two work diagrams, one for the normal force, the other one for the kinetic friction. And applicable concepts, you're going to use conservation of energy to solve for the distance traveled by the sled. And coordinate system is specified. We have right as positive, up as positive. And then we're trying to solve for D. And unit is meters, and it's just a scalar quantity, so we don't have to worry about the sign. And then let's plan the solution. So first we have to identify the equations we are going to use. So we are going to use the conservation of energy equation. Initial kinetic energy plus initial potential energy plus work done by non-conservative forces is equal to final kinetic energy plus final potential energy. And let's see which terms are going to be zero. Potential energy, initial and final, is zero because the sled is moving at height is equal to zero level. And kinetic energy, initial, is not zero, plus work non-conservative is equal to kinetic energy final. So I'm going to leave it as it is. And then let's move on to the next equation. The next one we're going to use is the equation for the work non-conservative. Work non-conservative is equal to magnitude of the force. In this case, we have the magnitude of the kinetic friction force magnitude of the displacement, and then the angle between the force and the displacement is 180 degrees, cosine 180. Work done by normal force is zero because the angle is 90 degrees, so I'm not going to worry about it. And then we need the kinetic friction force is equal to coefficient of kinetic friction force times the normal force. And we need to solve for the normal force. For that, we are going to use the component form of the Newton's second law, net force. Summation of the forces in y direction is equal to mass times acceleration in y direction. So let's execute this plan. It looks like a lot of equations, but it's really simple. So net force in y direction is equal to mass times acceleration in y direction. And acceleration in y direction is zero because the sled is not moving in the vertical plane. It's just moving in the horizontal plane. So in y direction, we have normal force positive, weight is negative. Normal force is simply equal to weight. Mass is 10 kilograms, mass times 9.8 meters per second squared. And we know 1 Newton is equal to 1 kilogram meters per second squared. So normal force is simply equal to 98 Newtons, right? So that would be it. And now I'm going to use this normal force to solve for the kinetic friction. Kinetic friction force is equal to coefficient of kinetic friction times the normal force. Coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.1 and the normal force is 98 newtons. 0.1 times 98 newtons, 9.8 newtons is the kinetic friction. It's the magnitude of the kinetic friction. Now let's see the next step. I'm going to use the conservation of energy equation. We know that potential energy is zero because the object is moving at h is equal to zero level. Potential energy is mgh. Height is zero, so that's zero. And final speed is zero because the sled comes to a rest. For that reason, kinetic energy final will become a zero. So initial kinetic energy plus work non-conservative is equal to zero. So initial kinetic energy half times mass times speed squared plus work non-conservative. So we have work done by kinetic friction force times the distance times cosine 180 is equal to zero. And I'm just going to substitute for the mass and the speed initial, and then we know the kinetic friction force is 9.8 newtons, and then distance traveled is an unknown, cosine 180 is equal to negative 1. And then you just have to solve for D. And I'm again reminding you, I didn't calculate the, I didn't actually include the work done by normal force here because it's just zero, because the angle between the normal force and the displacement vector is 90 degrees, cosine 90 is zero. So now I did the calculation for D, it's just 20 kilogram meter squared second squared divided by 9.8 newtons, and we know that 1 newton is equal to 1 kilogram meters per second squared, and you will see the units will cancel out and you get the final answer in meters. So distance traveled is 2.04 meters. Okay, so is the solution complete? Yes, the solution is complete. We calculated the distance traveled by the sled. We used conservation of energy. The unit is correct. We got meters, and then it's a scalar quantity, so there's no sign. The magnitude of the answer is reasonable. And now let's see the energy chart. So initially, let's assume kinetic energy is just 3 units, and then initial potential energy is 0, final kinetic energy, final potential energy, all that is 0. So whatever the initial kinetic energy you had in the system should be converted into work done by non-conservative forces. So that should be negative.